Hi, my name is Dr. John Shim, and I'd like to discuss a very specific topic that's often a finding on x-rays or MRIs of the spine. The term is lordosis. It basically describes the backward curvature of the spine. To go back to some basic anatomy, the whole spine from the head to the tailbone is composed of two backward-oriented curves and two forward-oriented curves. If you look at the side view of the whole spine, just below the head is your neck. In what is considered normal anatomy, the neck curves backwards. As stated before, this backward curvature is called lordosis. The upper back, or the thoracic spine, then curves forwards. This forward curvature of the spine, which is called kyphosis, also allows development of a concave space in the upper body, which then forms a protective cage with the ribs to house structures such as the lungs, the heart, and the liver. The lower back, which is called the lumbar spine, then curves backwards again. Then, at the bottom of your spine, the so-called sacrum forms another forward curvature and becomes another protective space with the pelvic bones to house your bowels. The net effect of these four curves is that it allows your head to remain balanced over your shoulders and the center of gravity fall over the top of your pelvis. When you stand normally, the center of your weight, or so-called sagittal balance, allows you to be most efficiently standing without expending too much energy trying to balance your body parts over the legs. So naturally, we assume that the neck and the lower back should have a normal lordosis curvature. Most people do not get x-rays of their spine when they are not hurting. So when people have pain, one of the tests often ordered by your doctor is an x-ray. Our radiologists will read the x-rays, and if there's lack of curvature, the report would indicate lack of lordosis. Because the person getting the x-ray is in pain and there's a finding of loss or lack of lordosis, the common sense assumption is that this loss of lordosis or straightening of the spine is an indication of some sort of injury or pain. But this is not the only reason people have lack of lordosis. One reason a person would have loss of lordosis may simply be positioning. Some people just take x-rays with their neck or back straight. Another reason is a person can have loss of lordosis secondary to the natural degenerative process. As the disc narrows, there is a straightening of the spine that occurs over time. But the most surprising reason why people have lack of lordosis or straightening of the spine is because that is just the way they are. Multiple research studies have identified loss or lack of lordosis or straightening of the spine as a normal variant of people's anatomies. X-rays of pain-free people will often demonstrate this loss of lordosis. So, while as a practicing doctor I do believe loss of lordosis may be a sign of pain or injury, I also know lack of lordosis or straightening of the spine may be just the normal degenerative process, or maybe an issue of positioning while taking the x-ray, or maybe the normal anatomy of that person. I hope I did not confuse your understanding about lordosis. While it may be considered a normal finding, lack of it may also be normal. This is Dr. John Shim, and I thank you for watching the video.